2020 Wednesday continues. Now, Sam Donaldson.
As you know, we're always in search of a diet that really works. And right now, a phenomenal movement is sweeping this country, gathering new converts every day. It combines two American passions, religion and a desire to lose weight. Deborah Roberts tells us in churches everywhere, people are gathering to read the Bible, pray, and diet. They say they're filling up on God rather than calories. But is it sacrilegious to ask God for help losing those extra pounds? Converts say no, because in addition to losing weight, they are satisfying a spiritual hunger also.
It's just minutes to airtime at The View, ABC's newest daytime talk show. Waiting in the wings for her cue is one of the day's guests, a woman who's new to national television, but who's getting celebrity-like attention.
Hi, Miss Shamblin.
Yes.
How are you? I'm Jackie Taylor, one of the producers here. My sister's on your diet.
You have to sign a copy of your book for my mom. Her birthday's tomorrow.
Are you doing the new diet?
Yeah.
My cousins are on that.
Oh, you're kidding.
And they've lost a lot of weight.
Her name is Gwen Shamblin, and she's a Tennessee dietitian who's come up with a revolutionary new program for losing weight.
America has a crush on food.
Have a crush on the Bible, not food, she says. That's the central idea behind her spiritually based program. It's called The Way Down Diet. In her best-selling book, Gwen says no food is off limits. Have butter, pizza, bacon, or even chocolate. But what you must also have is a relationship with God.
Our God is an awesome God. He reigns from heaven above and in.
At encouragement rallies like this held around the country, Way Down members support each other.
So anybody that feels like it, come on up.
And give testimonials about how much weight they've lost. Some even bring reminders of their former heavier bodies.
That was a size 26, and I'm now size 8.
This is the only pair that I saved. I've lost 95 pounds.
Others pull out old photos.
I did not even feel as if I were a part of the family of man. I've lost 156 pounds now.
All of the members usually have words of thanks to Gwen for helping them lose the weight and keep it off. Something no other diet has been able to do for them.
I just have always wanted to see you.
But there's another, far greater debt of gratitude that they all have in common.
I tried everything else, man-made, and it didn't work. But God did it.
And thanks to God.
Most of all, I want to praise God.
They all thank God.
And I'm teaching people, look, you've got to turn to God. He can do better than Rocky Road ice cream. He can make you feel better than a binge. And that's what we're asking people to go back and do, is fill their heart up with that relationship.
Gwen, who's never been more than 20 pounds overweight herself, tells followers that overeating stems from a deeper problem. Experts tend to agree, saying that people use food to soothe troubles that often reach back to childhood. But Gwen insists that overeaters are instead suffering from a spiritual void, which they're trying to fill by eating. Her advice? Pray when you want that extra piece of cake. Turn to the Bible instead of the refrigerator, and you'll end up thinner and more fulfilled.
They don't feel the magnetism to the food anymore. God is showing them, I can deliver you.
A lot of people would hear you, though, and sort of roll their eyes and say, come on, so you're telling me to just pray the pounds off?
What we're talking about is a choice. They are making a choice to run to God instead of the food.
Those who come to the Way Down workshop sign up for a 12-week course. For $100 a person, they'll go to the classes and talk about their progress, which they record in their journals. They also keep pictures of where they've been and where they hope to be.
My smallest was a size 2.
No.
They're shown a videotape. A big part of Way Down is teaching people a new way of eating.
They can only think about food when their stomach growls. And that eliminates a lot of focus on food.
So you're saying only eat when you're really hungry?
Yes.
And only eat until the point where you're slightly full?
Right. And you don't have to be legalistic with that. Because if you mess up, so what? You just wait for the next stomach hunger.
These women from New York and Connecticut strongly believe in Way Down. Some have been members for a few months, others a couple of years. Collectively, they've lost nearly 300 pounds, and all agree that retraining yourself to eat is the key to successfully losing weight. They all told us that over the years, food had become an escape from anger, depression, and stress. Diane Powell says her stress surfaced after the birth of her last two children.
I am an emotional eater. When stress comes, I reach for ice cream or I reach for that extra helping of food or whatever. You know, hey, food, come and satisfy me. Make me feel better. When God is saying, hey, I'm here for you, I'll make you feel better. Just come talk to me.
Gina Barku of New Rochelle, New York, also learned to control her emotional eating through spirituality. She's lost more than 50 pounds.
But I still struggle. There are days when I see certain foods and I know that I'm not experiencing true hunger, but my mind says, take it.
And what do?
I begin to read the Bible. I begin to listen to music. I begin to talk to God.
She says she also draws strength from listening to the audio cassettes Way Down provides.
When you obey and stop at the 5 bites of the entree,
and writing in her journal.
I remember writing in my journal saying, you know, Lord, I need help. I feel out of control. I know it's connected to this weight.
Heavy since childhood, Gina had no luck with any other diet until Way Down. Now she says her goal is to please God by not overeating. She says she's amazed by the freedom she has.
Like a strawberry shake, Big Mac, extra value meal.
You're not in any type of bondage to anything, to the scale, to exchange groups, to going to a counselor to be weighed in weekly.
She still orders her favorite foods, but what's different now is the way she eats them. Way Down teaches that it's helpful to cut your food in half, saving the rest for the next time you're hungry, and to savor each bite. Eat with a fork, even if it's French fries. Chances are you'll eat just a few. We wondered about Gwen's dining ideas, so I took her to lunch. We both ordered the same thing, a tuna club sandwich with avocado, bacon, and onion rings. It sounded pretty fattening to me.
So we've got onion rings here. This looks like trouble.
Oh, no, this is an opportunity.
Should we feel guilty, though?
No, not at all. Rings?
The first step she takes is to evaluate her food using a rating system.
I would take a bite of the tuna. There's obviously some beautiful meat here. And the avocado, whatever, and find out what my favorite bites are.
By doing that, she only fills up on the food she loves.
And I'm going to try the Napoleon. It looks like it might be the richest, and I'm going for that.
It all sounds great, but is it healthy? According to nutrition experts we spoke with, it seems pretty sound, but they caution that a balanced diet is important, even if you're eating less and losing weight. Participants clearly seem to be shedding pounds, but what about the idea that you're pleasing God by doing so?
Are you worried at all that you're sending the message that God only likes thin people?
Mm-mm. I don't think he looks at the outside so much as the heart. That's what he says. I think he's jealous. He's jealous of us worshiping, you know, objects more than him.
Objects like food. Gwen says they should not be idolized, just enjoyed. And when we visited the Way Down offices in Franklin, Tennessee, we saw that they do indeed practice what they preach. Once a week, the whole staff gathers together for a barbecue. They had, of all things, gooey sticky buns offered before a staff meeting. And even Gwen has her own private stash, a drawer full of candy, which she eats sparingly.
He's the genius behind brownies. He's the expert chef behind lasagna. He's the one who created blue cheese dressing, and I don't mean low fat. But what he's begging us not to do is worship the created more than the creator.